Right. After getting class object in either of these three approaches, no? I want to get some details about class. How we are able to get details about this particular class, no? First one, I want to get name of the class. To get name of the class, we have to use a method from class. That method is public string getter name method. By using this method, public string get name method, we are able to get name of the respective class, employee. Next one, I want to get superclass data. If you want to get superclass, no, we need to use a method. That method is public class get superclass. In this get superclass, S is capital but C is small only. This get superclass is able to return superclass metadata in the form of class object. This is one method. Next one. I want to get all the implemented interfaces details in the form of class array. So for that purpose, we need to use a method. That method is public class array get interfaces method. Public class array get interfaces method. Then get interfaces method is able to take all the implemented interfaces, and their metadata will be stored in the form of class objects. All these class objects are managed in the form of class array. The class array data will be returned. So by using these three methods, we are able to get some minimum information about our class. Now let us see programmatic views about all these things, no? Superclass information and current class information, access modifiers information. If you want to get access modifiers of this particular class, we need to use two-step procedure. Right, step number one, we have to use a method directly. That method is public int get modifiers method. We need to use. It will return an integer value. That integer value must be passed as parameter to a static toString method. That means public static string toString method is available in the modifier class. Now this toString method will take integer value which is written from get modifiers method. Then it able to return the specified access modifiers list which are declared for the respective class here. By using this, we are able to get information about our class. So getName method can be used to get name of the class. Get superclass method can be used to get superclass metadata in the form of class object. GetInterfaces method can be used to get all the implemented interfaces metadata in the form of class objects which are available in the form of class array. GetModifiers method can be used to get an integer value which is representing a combination of access modifiers which we specified. Public static string, a toString method will be used to return exact access modifiers list what you are having there now. So now I want to show all these things in practical view. Now let us see one Java program where to get information about a particular class game. Right. So for example, I'll take one simple Java program. Now here I'm going to provide. Okay, now see this one. I want to take a Java file. File new Java. A Java class is open. Now I want to declare this class public class employee implements java.io.serializable interface comma clonable interface. Two interfaces I want to implement inside this public employee class. I want to take only this information. I don't want to go for any other one. Otherwise, and better to declare these classes, which one do you know? Abstract class, public and abstract. Now here, what are the access modifiers we provided there? Public and abstract are access modifiers. Class is a keyword. employee is a class name, and super class for this employee class is objective class. Well, this class is implementing two interfaces. The two interfaces are java.io.dot serializable and next one is clonable. Now in this case, I have not provided any data. I have not managed any variables or any method or any constructor. Just my requirement is getting normal details about our class employee. So let me save this now. I want to save this in a location D drive. In a D drive, Durga apps, I prepared a folder. Now inside this, just I want to save, its name is employee.java. It is mandatory to save the Java file name is employee.java. Why? Because class employee is a public class. It's okay, computed. Next, let me take some Java main class. This is test class now. Now inside this test class, I want to take throws exception for the sake of program safety purpose. Next, I'll go for some implementation part inside this main method. As I want to get metadata of class employee, first I need to create class object for the respective employee class. So for the purpose, class C is equal to, just I will use class dot for name of employee. Already I explained to you, in a previous we are able to get employee class object, that means class object with respect to employee class. Just I am using first approach there. Class C is equal to class dot for name of employee. Now just I want to display name of the class. Name of the class, if you want to display name, plus we need to provide C dot get name method. Here and should be capture get name method. So it able to provide which one? Name of the class. Next one, system dot out println of, I want to get super class data. Super class. Super class details we are able to get by calling which one again now? C dot get a super class method. Over which it will return class reference. On it we need to access which method they know? Get name method. Automatically super class name we are able to get. Next one, system.out.println of implemented interfaces data we want to get. If you want to get implemented interfaces details now, we need to take class array first of all. Class array CL is equal to, next one, we need to access C dot get interfaces method. Whenever we are calling get interfaces method, automatically we are able to get which one there? All the implemented interfaces metadata in the form of class array. Now we want to display the data. System.out.print of interfaces list. Just I want to manage it now. So for the purpose I need to take for loop there. Now inside this for loop, I need to take class C, CLS colon, CL is a reference. Just it is a for each loop, we can identify. It will perform number of iterations over class array. It will take at each and every iteration, it will take a class object. The class object value will be assigned to CLS. From the CLS, we are able to get which one? The name of the respective class. Now again, just we need to specify system.out.printf CLS. Get name method we need to use plus some space we are able to provide. Then after completion of all these things, I need to bring cursor to the next line there. Right, up to now, name of the class we are getting, super class name we are getting, interfaces list we are getting there. Next I want to get which one they know, access modifiers information of this one. So for the purpose I need to use which one, like directly int I is equal to, and we need to use C dot get a modifiers method, we need to use that. After getting this integer value, modifiers combination respect to integer value, we need to pass this integer value as parameter to which one they know, get a modifiers method. So for the purpose we need to use system.out.println of access modifiers. Access modifiers we need to provide. Now here, what we need to be specify now, java dot, otherwise modifier dot toString method we need to use. where we need to pass which one? I is a parameter. Modifier is a class available in java.lang.reflect package. So we must import java.lang.reflect.star, that we need to import there. Then only we are able to utilize this modifier class, otherwise we are unable to use this modifier class here clearly. That's all. This is about our program. I am going to save this program in the same directory. Now here, Durga Apps is a folder I prepared here. Durga Apps. Now inside this I want to save test.java. That's all. Two files are available. I want to compile both of them. Next I need to go for D drive and CD Durga Apps. Now inside this I need to use Java C star.java. Both the Java files I compiled. Successfully I compiled here. I want to execute test class now. If I execute test class, we are getting some information about our class employee. Now, name of the class is employee. Superclass name is java.lang.object. Interfaces list is which one? java.io.serializable. java.lang.clonable we are getting here now. Next one, access modifiers, public and abstract we are getting. Now, this is a way to get all the information about a particular class. This is what exactly the reflection API we are using to get the metadata of a particular class.